My name is Teresa Wilson. I'm a breast cancer survivor. I'm a mother, I'm a friend, I'm a wife, and I'm a daughter. I was diagnosed with breast cancer 7 years ago, very unexpectedly, not expecting anything from my annual mammogram, but was met with the three words that most people feel that they never want to hear, or they're so scared to hear it, and that was, you have cancer. And the initial shock and feeling of having to face your mortality is very real, and it's very big. And I noticed and felt over the first couple of days after that happened that it wasn't just me who had cancer. It was my family, it was my friends, it was my colleagues. Everybody had, something had happened, and a lot of people didn't know how to talk to me about it. A lot of people didn't know how to react to me about it. So here you are in an environment or in a place where you are scared, you are fearful, you don't know what is going to happen, you don't know where you are going to get your strength from, and people around you all of a sudden start treating you differently because they don't know what to say to you, they don't know how to handle the situation. So from a supporter perspective, for me it was very important for people to not hide what it was that I was going through. So don't be scared to speak to a person who has been diagnosed with breast cancer. The most important message that I received and that I've been giving to people that, and ladies and men that have been diagnosed with breast cancer, is I am there. I am there in whichever way you need me, in whichever way I can help. In any way that I can make you feel stronger or better or more positive. So whenever you're ready, please know that I'm there. And I think that is a very important piece of the support structure, is I had friends that I could phone and say, I don't want you to talk to me at all. Don't say a word, just listen. And for 5 minutes, I could go on a rant about, I'm scared, I hate this, I'm not feeling well. And that friend would just listen. And at the end of the call say, Teresa, you feeling better? And I go, yes, I'm feeling great, thank you very much, and put the phone down. So I think from a perspective of letting someone know that you're there in whichever way they need you is very important. A lot of people feel all of a sudden really scared to speak to a person that's been diagnosed with cancer. And that hurts very often, because you believe that as the cancer patient, you believe or you think that this person is really going to be supportive. And then they pull away and they don't talk to you, and you feel really, really heart sore. So even if it's a hard thing to say, I find that people just walked up to me and said, Teresa, I'm sorry for what you're going through, and I'm there when you need it. And I think that message is a message that a survivor and a cancer patient needs to hear. Often the most important thing to hear and to see is that there's hope. So the first important thing that you can do as a cancer patient supporter is try and get them into a support group, into a small group, into a big group, just where they are surrounded by other people in the same position, other people with the same fears, but also people that have already gone through the process and gone through the journey. Because it is that piece of hope and that seeing that people are okay that really helps for the cancer patient. And in my case, I was very, very lucky. I actually met ladies on my first day of chemo who started talking to me and invited me into a support group. And during the 9 months that I went through treatment, that was probably one of the strongest things for me, was engaging with them, talking to them, asking, when did your hair start falling out? What did you do? How did this happen to you? Did you feel this? And that support from a you know where I am point of view is quite important. So I reckon one of the biggest things you can do as somebody to support a breast cancer patient is find them survivors, find them people to talk to. I was asked by a lady who worked with me to please speak to her sister-in-law who had just been diagnosed. So this is somebody I didn't know, I'd never met her before, but the empathy that I felt for her was huge, because I immediately knew and felt what she was going to go through. So I sent her a WhatsApp and I said, this is who I am. This is what has happened to me. I am a survivor. Whenever you feel ready, you can have a talk. We can have a talk. And we spoke on WhatsApp for the better part of 9 months. I never met her. We only spoke over WhatsApp, and she only sent me messages when she felt that it was necessary to know, or to ask, or to find some comfort. And I think that to me is a very important thing. Is one, don't shy away. Don't not speak to the patient. Don't not speak to the person. They actually do need to hear from you. Two, feel comfortable to speak to them and to ask them what they want, what they need from you. Can you take them to chemo? Can you provide some meals for them? Can you have can you collect their children from school? Anything that could just look like you are there and you are supporting. From a cancer patient perspective, the period of treatment is, it's huge. It's all about needles and blood tests and white blood cell counts and surgery and chemo and radiation. And it's a whirlwind. And that person doesn't, they don't know what's going to happen next, what is next in line, how do they get to the end. But making sure that you are there to say, you know what, this is a journey. And it's a journey that I'm with you. I'm going to go through this journey with you in terms of supporting you emotionally or in any other way you need. And there is an end line, there is a finish line, and we're going to get there together. And making sure that you support them in that way, and that they always know that you're there. I think for me, what was also very important is my son was 5 when I was diagnosed, and my husband, I didn't realize at the time what a great shock it was for him to hear about my diagnosis. You almost become a little bit selfish because, you know, I've just been diagnosed with cancer, so it's all about me. You don't realize the trauma that people around you and family and husbands and wives actually go through. And I remember us talking about it one day, and he's not somebody who opens up. He doesn't really talk about his feelings. And I asked him, I said to him, the one way that you can help me as my husband through this journey is just make sure you're okay. I don't have the capacity, emotionally or physically, to worry about you, okay, you as well. So please make sure that you're okay. And I think from a spouse's perspective, to sit your wife down and say, I'm gonna make sure I'm okay. I'm gonna be strong, I'm gonna be positive, I'm gonna be there for you. And when you feel that you're not, and you feel that you need to have a beer or you need to get out, then do it. Do it, but make sure that you stay strong, because that is what your partner needs from you. And then I think the last thing, from a perspective of being a mom going through it and having a small child, was the decision on how you explain that and how you tell the little one what your mommy is going to go through or what they're going to see. And for them, the biggest thing from a breast cancer treatment perspective is the loss of your hair. You lose it quite quickly, and you lose it totally. And especially for Jordan, my son, at the time when I asked them to shave my hair because I didn't want to wait for it to fall out. And over the period of my treatment, I realized that that was the biggest thing for Jordan, was to do the hair, to actually shave my hair, to then ask me to please tell him when I was going to take my beanie off, because he said that it shocked him every time he saw me with no hair. And then being totally elated and so happy when my hair started growing again. So for children, it's what they see more than what they feel. I believe that for Jordan, it was knowing that when he comes back from school, I'm there to tell him that I was going to go through a journey where I was not going to feel well. I was not always going to be strong, but I was always going to be there. And I made a promise to him, and I made a promise to my husband, that I will survive. And it was a journey that I was going to finish, and it would take everything from me, but I was going to do that. And I think from a survivor perspective is to make a patient feel that way, that it's just a period. It's not a life sentence. It's not a death sentence. It's a journey. And the more positive they are, and the more positive you can make them, the better it is. Because I truly believe cancer the fighting of cancer is also a positive mind plays a very important role. My treatment was in 2012, up until December 2012, and started working again in 2013. And this is something I don't say to a cancer patient. I say that to the people around them, that the hardest part of cancer, of the cancer journey, is for me was the year after I had cancer and I had the treatment, because it is. It's all about you, about the patient, about blood tests, about surgery, about everything else. And then all of a sudden you go back into the world and you don't know who you've changed. You don't know, you don't really know what you want or how you want it or how you want people to respond to you. And the world expects you to be Teresa again. So, okay, you weren't on a journey, but now you're back and now you're Teresa. And I think for a survivor and for a patient to realize that cancer is a journey of not just treatment. It's a journey of how you emotionally react to something that happened to you, and to accept that you are a survivor from day one, because you make a decision from the day that you are diagnosed, you are already a survivor. And bear in mind that your support group is probably the best group that you can use afterwards, because you sit in a group with women and everybody is going through that same thing. I'm not quite sure whether people still want to sit and chat with me, or whether people feel sorry for me because I had cancer, or one day I wanted them to feel sorry for me because I had cancer, and then the next day I'm like, don't feel sorry for me. There's nothing wrong with me. So there's a very big emotional roller coaster, especially in the first year after you've completed your treatment, in terms of what you want and who you want and whether you want people to actually know or not know, or whatever the case is. For me, I am an outgoing person. I'm an extrovert. I used social media as a platform, and I got incredible support from people on the platform. So as a runner, when I was diagnosed, I decided to treat the cancer journey and the cancer treatment as a marathon, and that each treatment is a water table and there is a finish line. And I used social media to post that every time, to say, I've now gone for number 5 of 12. So I'm always almost halfway, and really got support from people that way. But then you get somebody who does not like to do that. They don't want it to be in the public eye. And those are people that I believe should really strongly consider becoming part of a support group. I think from a perspective of survivors, and what we like to do is we, and I say we because I've heard more than one woman say this to me, and I believe we are people and women who want to pay it forward. We want to let a person who is going through it now know that we're there. And it's not necessary to become friends in a support group. It is just necessary to speak to a survivor. So even if it is somebody you don't know and you reach out, you don't need to become friends. You can just use the support from a person who's been there, they've done it, they've got the t-shirt, and they can give you some perspective in terms of things that you're going through. My oncologist believes to this day that the fact that I was fit and healthy at the time really helped me to handle the treatment better. So I was able to withstand, I think, a lot of the side effects of the chemo, even though it did make me feel pretty sick. But for me, as a support group, I had a running group of support people who didn't know what I was going through with the cancer, but who said to me, we will be there. The start line will be there. The next race will be there. We're going to see you there. So just make sure you are okay.